Hello students, so following are the AD lab OYOVA questions. So you will see here around 50 OYOVA questions, 50 to 60 OYOVA questions. So first question is, what is digital system and why binary system is used in digital logic? What is logic circuit? So digital system represents information and which makes use of binary systems. Because binary system makes use of either 0 or 1 to represent value, and the value can be characterized by either presence of or absence of current in a digital circuit. So normally digital circuits, the components in digital circuits work like either off or on. So this property is characterized by the value of the binary system. That's why binary system makes use of digital logic. Now the next question is, what is logic circuit? A logic circuit is a digital circuit or a switching circuit or any kind of two-state circuit that duplicates a mental process. So I repeat, a logic circuit is a digital circuits or a switching circuits or any kind of two-state circuit that duplicates a mental process, that is called as a logic circuits. Now next one is a defined number system. What are the different types of number system? What is a bit? What is the difference between digital and analog signal? A number system is a collection of numbers, that is called as a number system. What are different types of number system? Different types of number systems we have is a binary number system, hexadecimal number system, octal system, and decimal system. So decimal system, here we use 0 to 9 digit. That's why it is called as a decimal. So the base is 10 or radix is 10. And binary system is makes use of either 0 or 1. That is also called as a bit. So what is a bit? It is a binary digit, 0 and 1. And binary system base is 2, radix is 2. And hexadecimal system, it makes use of 16 digits. So it is 0 to 9. After that, A, B, C, D, E, F. After that, 10, 12, 13 till 19. 1A, 1B, 1C, 1D, 1E, then 20, something like that. And octal system makes use of 0 to 7, that is base is 8 or radix is 8. Now what is digital signal and what is analog signal? A analog signal is a continuous signal. A signal whose amplitude can take any value between given limits, that is called as analog signal. A digital signal is a signal which can take a discrete value between the defined limits, that is called as a digital signal. So now what is hexadecimal system? You have already explained what is hexadecimal system. Hexadecimal system is a system, it is a number system where it makes use of 16 digits, that is 0 to 9 and A, B, C, C, D, E, F. So hexadecimal systems are used to reduce the complexity of representing information in binary 1001. So in hexadecimal system, these 0100010, all these are grouped into 4 bits, and corresponding value is represented. That is called as hexadecimal system. What is a BCD? BCD is a binary coded decimal system, which is used to represent 0 to 9 by using either 4-bit binary bits or 8-bit binary bits. Then define gate. What is TTL and what is ECL? Define gate. Gate is a electronic device which has one or more input and only one output. That is called as a gate. Now, what are the different types of gate? Different types of gates are like AND gate, OR gate. Then we have OR gate, we have exclusive OR gate, etc. Then what do you mean by universal gate? Universal gate is the gate by using that we can implement basic functions such as AND, OR, NOT. That is called as universal gate. What is TTL and ECL? TTL is called as transistor logic, and ECL is called as emitter coupled logic. So now, So what do you mean by universal gate? We told you what is the difference between universal gate. Universal gate is used to implement implement a basic function, the normal NAND and NOR are this is the universal gate. What is the difference between positive logic and negative logic? What is active low signal? So what is the difference between a positive logic and a negative logic? Positive logic is the system which makes use of 5 volt to represent logical 1 and 0 volt to represent 0. And negative logic is the system where it makes use of 0 volt to represent logical 1 and 5 volt to represent logical 0. That is called as a positive logic and negative logic. What is active low signal? Active low signal is the signal in which signal must be low to cause something action. That is, active low refers to the concept in which signal must be low to cause something to happen or to indicate that something has happened. That is called as active low signal. So that means when the signal is low, the either IC will be get switched on. For example, in the microprocessor, in the 74151 multiplexer, we have pin number 7, which is a strobe signal. It is active low signal. When this signal, we will connect it to ground. So when it is connected to ground, then the IC will get switched on. Otherwise, IC will not get enabled. That is active low signal. So now, defined De Morgan's theorem. What do you mean by De Morgan's theorem? So De Morgan's theorem, first theorem, there are two theorems. First theorem is complement of logical sum equals to the logical product of the complements. In terms of the circuits, I can say NOR gate equal to the bubbled AND gate. Second theorem, it says complement of the logical product equals to the logical sum of the complements. That is, NAND gate is equal to bubbled OR gate. NAND gate is equal to bubbled OR gate. So first one is something like this. A bar into B bar is equal to, so we have something called as A plus B whole bar. That is one. Second one is A bar plus B bar is equal to A B whole bar. That is, you can say NAND gate equal to bubbled OR gate. NAND gate equal to bubbled OR gate. Next one is NOR gate equal to bubbled AND gate. This is the information about this one. So now what is the next one is, what is hardware description language? Hardware description language, it is nothing but textual description of a digital circuit. So this is used to describe the digital circuit and used in simulation. So there are two types of hardware description languages. So one is Verilog, second one is VHDL. VHDL means a very high speed integrated hardware description language, which is more versatile than Verilog. Verilog is used for some simple circuit description, some simple circuit simulation, but VHDL is used for very high integrated circuits. So that is the difference between next one is a defined gate. So defined gate. Gate is an electronic device which has one or more input and only one output. We have already told. I explained different scale of IC integration. So different scale of IC integrations are SSI, MSI, LSI, and last one is VLSI. First one is LSI. First one is SSI, small scale integration. Second one is called as small scale integration. So it is used whenever the gates are less than 10. Second one is LSI, which is used whenever the gates are less than 50. Third one is MSI, medium scale integration. used whenever the grades are less than 100, and last one is a large scale.